Folklore is Taylor Swift's 8th studio album. Released unannounced in July 2020, it was recorded after the cancellation of her tour, Lovefest, because of the ongoing global pandemic. Written and produced during quarantine, the album is claimed to have been created through a stream of consciousness, memories that have developed into stories and tales. According to an interview given to Billboard magazine, Swift says, "It started with imagery, visuals that popped into my mind and piqued my curiosity. Pretty soon, these images in my head grew faces or names and became characters. I found myself not only writing my own stories, but also writing about or from the perspective of people I've never met, people I've known, or those I wish I hadn't. An exiled man walking the bluffs of a land that isn't his own, wondering how it all went so terribly, terribly wrong. An embittered tormentor showing up at the funeral of his fallen object of obsession. A 17-year-old standing on a porch, learning to apologize. Love-struck kids wandering up and down the Evergreen High Line. My grandfather, Dean, landing at Guadalcanal in 1942. A misfit widow getting gleeful revenge on the town that cast her out. A tale that becomes folklore is one that is passed down and whispered around, sometimes even sung about. The lines between fantasy and reality blur, and the boundaries between truth and fiction becomes almost indiscernible. Speculation over time becomes fact. Myths, ghost stories and fables, fairy tales and parables, gossip and legend, someone's secret written in the sky for all to behold." The album, more than carrying a name, bears an identity with something unseen and quietly being handed down from behind. A backstage direction rather than a pointer. It lends the idea of folklore quite interesting. Was also released on July 24th, 2020, which was my birthday. The word folklore can be easily broken into two halves, folk and lore. It is a collective knowledge, stories and tales of a people or a group that is passed down through generations, leading to beliefs, superstition and even proto-religions. Many cultures and people have no written material to be conserved and taken into the future, relying exclusively on the whispers of the elders into a youth's ear and a child's fear to be kept alive. Myths, legends, tales to tell in the dark or under the sun are ways to keep a story alive and to develop an engagement between a life of needs and functions with another of thought, philosophy, and culture. For anthropologists, the term culture is a complicated one to elaborate and describe. It is all at the same time vague and too precise. Claude Lévi-Strauss, when talking about myths and their meaning, says that the theme presents two problems for the mythology researcher. The first is a theoretical problem of great importance. Sometimes anthropologists collected myths that more or less resemble fragments. They are disconnected stories that follow each other without any relationship between them. Some other times they find very coherent mythologies, separated in chapters, following a very logical sequence. The second problem is a more practical. When does myth end and history begin? Different from the written official history of nations and peoples, researched and produced by historians, lore and myth are mainly the realm of anthropology. For centuries, anthropologists traveled to distant places to collect and try to decipher the tales of the peoples who did not write on paper, but read in the stars and on the land. Lore. It is deeply connected to traditions, to culture, to a group's knowledge. It is the untold tale of a place by the language of the environment. In a fiction narrative, lore most of the time is clumped and attached to the book's history. its religions, magic systems, old knowledge, cautionary tales, and so forth. However, history and lore are quite and definitely different. Whilst the former is formal and direct, the latter is quiet and insidious. Lore, in a narrative, is the most exterior of the possible layers or arches of the writing. It is the very fabric of the universe, ensemble. If we look at the Lord of the Rings, what is lore, what is history, what is story, and what is plot? The lore is the music of the Ainur, the first three songs of the Eru Ilúvatar, the visions of the word given to the Valar and the Maiar. The lore is the told and the untold, the start and the end, and the nuances in between. History is more formal. The tale of lords of Numenor and the kings of Gondor, the many ownerships of Minas Morgul, the heraldic of Rohan, and the many documents Gandalf researches to find more about the One Ring. All those are factual rather than tales. They are documented and known rather than whispered and remembered. John Yorke, writer and author of Into the Woods, a method book of how stories are made and the elements that form a coherent writing piece, has this to say about untold things. Once upon a time, immediately after you read that opening phrase, you know you're going to encounter a setting, and in that place, a series of events will occur. The lore is the setting. It is the thing left untold. It's building your world by showing and not telling, but also by telling. A level below the lore, we have the written history of a word. We are talking documents, books, the full exposition we get from specific characters, specific circumstances. When Paul Atreides learns about the Freemen before arriving in Arrakis, when Moraine tells of the Manathrin in the Two Rivers, when Gandalf tells of the Rings of Power, that is lore being manifested, its history being written or deciphered. Knowing and writing about history is quite important for a more structured piece such as The Lord of the Rings or The Way of Kings by Brandon Sanderson, but not essential. History and lore are one and the same in Patrick Rothfuss, The Name of the Wind. Whilst history is almost non-existent in Annihilation by Jeff Vandermeer. The word lives and breathes through its history, and in an epic fantasy or a space opera, the way the narrative is brought into perspective is through history and the effects the events of the novel will have on the future of its past. What is the story in Dune? Paul and his family arrive in Arrakis by imperial decree to try and contain the planet's indigenous population whilst producing credits through spice manufacturing. What about Star Wars? A farmer boy raised by his uncle and aunt set out on an adventure with his friends and finds himself saving the universe whilst being trained on the Force and finally meeting his father. The story is the current set of events taking part in the narrative. It is the beginning and end, the movement from acts 1, the setting, 2, the climax, and 3, the conclusion. It is the tell me about this movie book in one sentence. But what happened during this tale? How does Luke end up in space in the first place? He has to jump on Han Solo's ship. What happened before that? He meets Obi-Wan Kenobi. What happened before that? His uncle and aunt were murdered by stormtroopers. Before that, well, you know that. That is what we call plot. To plot a story is to set a point by point, step by step, scene by scene, moving the pieces one stage after the other. The plot is the most fluid and most evident of the layers of narrative, is what we are reading or watching at the moment. Luke's plot takes him from being a farmer in Tatooine to a Jedi in Endor. At the same time, other plots are happening alongside it. Han goes from being a smuggler to a rebel general. Leia starts as a damsel in distress and becomes a leader and a fighter. Those are the main plot lines within the story. Others are side plot or auxiliary plots. Obi-Wan's is quick and swift, aiding Luke to reach his next step. Darth Vader's is slow and painful, and mostly apart from the main cast, but from time to time they collapse and touch. And finally, the characters themselves. Their characteristics, flaws, failures, and successes will ignite the plots. Luke's hope will make him never give up. Frodo's determination and Sam's loyalty will give them the will to take another step up Mount Doom. Paul's curiosity and training will see him become a leader. Those features will ignite the plots, which in turn will turn the story, which will then move history forward, and what has been will one day become legend, myth and lore once again. Thank you very much for watching. This has been a very interesting writing, very interesting script for me to write. I have much more on my courses on writing, academic or fiction writing. This was a discussion on lore, characters, plot, story. But if you want to know more, follow the YouTube channel, follow my socials. I'll leave all the links down in the description, along with the bibliography that I used to write this script. And keep in touch. Thank you very much.